Alright guys, this is Dally and welcome back to Farming Simulator 17. So when we were last here, I believe the combine had finished, so we'll start the fertilizer here. And we'll move the combine back into its home. So I think this episode we're going to do a little more with the sheep. Probably buy another 10. I believe I buy them at 10 at a time. Just drop them here. Yep, so we'll buy 10 more sheep. And we'll probably look at what other options we could make money with. Because wood chips are going to be very sporadic, right? Because the wood chip prices need to go back up closer to that 190 mark before I will do more wood chips. Right? Because we don't want to waste our time, so we want to get the most out of this that we can. So where's the trailer for this? It's not very big, but for realism, you wouldn't have it sit on. There it is, okay. You're stuck. Alright, so let's fix this. This is a bad problem. Right, because he's just sitting there burning away at our fertilizer. I don't know if you can do the whole width. Yep, you are doing the whole width. Perfect. Okay. So let's get the combine put away. Properly, of course. To go straight. Let's start with straight. Again, I think the other way is actually correct. Steering is throwing me off a little bit. Okay. Let's just put it away right here. Back it up just a little bit. Okay. So he's put away. He's not very dirty. A little dirty, but not enough that I'm terribly concerned with it. So let's go grab the fertilizer. We'll empty the tippers and then this same tractor here, the beacon's on, will be the one that we use for seeding. Maybe we'll look at buying another seeder, or at least leasing another seeder. Flip it around here and put it on the front while we transport. So that way we can do more at a time. What was it, home? Yeah. I gotta figure out what I'm gonna do with that little space right there. It's kind of like inconvenient with the fence. So gotta figure out what we're gonna do. So we are pushing the limits on this tractor right now. He's got the fertilizer hooked on the front, And he's got these crops. Is it filling up or? There we go. Eventually that is going to empty out. We won't have the ugly looking one that I dropped. Just reminding us of how bad I was with using this tractor actually as the front loader. No, I'm not gonna buy from there. That's ridiculous. We might look at using the pickup. Not that the pickup would be very good for this, but use the pickup to actually take these tippers full of probably soybean, one full of soybean, the other full of canola, out to sell. It's not, I like how it slips because it's heavy. And he probably doesn't have as good traction because all the weight's on the front of the tractor. Which is not what it's designed for. Okay, drop you there. I have a feeling that in real life you would just set it down, and so you probably hydraulic lower these lifts and set it on the ground before you detached it. Not that it would actually detach like that anyway. Ooh. That is not even the implement that I want. Alright, let's go. With a really dirty cedar. Man. There we go. So the question is, where is the... There's the pickup. Yep, I gotta leave the engine on, or follow me doesn't like it so much. Let's get this guy seeding. We'll do soybean on these fields and canola on the little field, so we're switching our crops on which side they're in, or which side they're on. I did add a mod, so how do I bring it up? I thought I added a mod. Give me a second, I'll bring it up. You. Nope. Alright, what?
No whisper target found.
Okay. Maybe I didn't add them at a mod. Basically, it was just supposed to tell me the prices where I should sell stuff real quickly without me having to look. But apparently, it doesn't want to turn on.
No whisper target found.
Up there it is. Okay, in the bottom left you see it's telling us what we can sell, where we should sell it. Let's see. So canola and wheat can go at the same place. So if we have enough to fill a tipper with wheat, I guess we'll just go ahead and do that if we're going that way. This is going to be a good time, guys. It's struggling and they're empty. Oh. And it's struggling because they're stuck. Hold on, let's change our angle of approach. We'll pull it this direction. There we go. Yep. Our little pickup is working really hard right now. Okay, so let's fill it up with wheat and granola. Right, I think we're going to stop waiting for great demands. We got to speed this up. So this is how we're going to do it. We're going to try to sell more frequently. And then canola. Yep, we do have the farm silo limits on this. So 100,000 is what we can store. I don't know if it'll be a problem. If it is a problem, we'll buy extra silos and we'll put them somewhere. Probably right around here, like that little gap that's next to this. Alright, so let's put the covers on these. Now, the question is, where's the bakery? The bakery? How do I get this to go away? How do I get this to go away? So the bakery is... Ah, whew! So the bakery is one of the closer sell points. Alright, so we are going to drag these guys. And I say literally drag, right? We are barely making it. Off to the bakery. Thank God that's the close one. Can you imagine if it was, like, over where the lumber yard is? We literally had to drive all the way around with zero control. Because I guarantee you when I try to take a turn at any kind of speed, the trailers are going to disagree with me. Yep, we're getting some speed going. You just gotta be careful. This hill is going to challenge us. Hopefully momentum gets us up it. Come on. Come on, guys. You can do it. Alright, I think we're good. Okay, so sell at the bakery. I think I actually go this way. Down the road. Because, of course, I'm going to get some really questionable looks as I pull up in a pickup to try to sell this. Alright, so it doesn't look like it's that way. Ah, here. This looks right. Alright, there's the wheat. And we should see in the bottom right there the price adjust. I mean, that's not bad. 9,500. And the canola will yield us more just because the price is higher. There we go, and 16,000. So that's exciting, right? We're making some money from the fields, trying to get ahead. But yeah, well, once we start rolling, I mean, we're kind of rolling now, but once we really roll, right, it just gets faster and faster. All right, so let's go take these back. Check. Might want to stop at the... Nope. You don't need to stop anywhere. We'll just take these straight back. And then while I wait, I will for the other workers to finish. Since I believe we struggled really badly last time with the trying to move the sheep with the pickup, we'll wait for a tractor to be done working on all of its doing its field work. So I'll probably chop down some, do some more lumbering, chop down some wood. So that way when we are in a good position to actually sell wood chips again, we've got a good pile ready to go. Okay. Alright, guys, so I will cut to when we've got to move one of the tractors. All right. Well, looks like a helper finished their task, so we'll drive over there. And which one? I think helper I was our cultivator. Couldn't make up my mind there and just drove straight into the telephone pole. But yeah, here, let's get rid of that. I'll make you go away. Ah, there we go. Oh, they both finished. Look at that. That is really convenient timing. So we'll move the cedar first. And then we'll move the cultivator. Alright, cedar. It is very convenient that we don't have to refill the cedar in between with the soybean. This guy is very dirty. He will have to be cleaned when he's done. Give the tractor a nice good bath. I suppose it's a little excessive overlap, but it's fine. So we're gonna go back to chopping wood. I had a small problem as I was chopping. You can see that it's right here. It kind of fell on the silo. So I had to cut it there. Oops. But yeah, so I'll climb on up here. I gotta figure out why he's not rolling off. That might be this branch, let's see. Yeah. Let's see if I can. Had a good. There we go. Let's see. Oh. Something's giving him a lot of support here, because he should just roll off. Based on how much is left. Eventually we'll run into the one that's keeping him up here. Because there's not a whole lot of weight that should be keeping him on the silo here. I might just cut it. Don't do this at home. This is a very dangerous maneuver. Oh yeah, that was it. Alright, let's grab this piece and just kind of move it over there. I've been cutting these smaller because these are kind of the pieces that were unwieldy, and you see that we lose that block at the end. I don't think we were actually getting anything from the wood chips for it, so I'm not terribly worried about it. So you see I have the pile down there. I'll just make a little pile right here. Save myself a little bit of headache. I wish it was more forgiving, the wood. Oh man. There we go. Alright. So we don't want those leaves attached. It's just gonna. There we go. Cut this there. Oh, I'm surprised it kept this piece here. But yeah, a little more manageable piece size. She was more forgiving on recognizing that I'm trying to chop the tree or chainsaw the tree, but whatever we can get. So yeah, I'll catch back up with you guys when we have to move probably the cedar and the cultivator again. Alright, looks like our cedar finished first, so we'll go grab him and move him over a field. We'll probably have to refill him, actually, so... Alright. You can tell I've been... Got some piles there, and I'm starting over here. I was looking at these guys, but I felt like they'd be in the way until I got some kind of... tool. I was thinking a leveler might actually allow me to push them around once I chopped them up. So, but until then, so let's go swap out for the canola here. Since we'll absolutely need more seed, so. Tell him to sit there. We'll go fill this back up. So that's not terribly realistic that I could just kind of hit that willy-nilly. Right. So we've got the seed. I think the next thing we'll buy is actually going to be new tractor. We'll probably lease a new tractor that can do a bigger... cultivator and cedar. So yeah. Yeah, you can see they're kind of, cost of them working is a little bit, not insignificant. See, how far did I get? So it's here. Alright guys, we'll do the same thing. I hate to do this, but there's work on the fields that we have to get done. And we don't really have enough tools yet to make an entertaining video as we work on other things. So I will sit here, keep chopping wood until we get to that point. We're not far off, I think. One, maybe two more harvests will get us there. So bear with me. The next couple of episodes will probably be... No, the next episode will not be like this. But the one after that will probably be another harvest video. Which I hope once we have more fields and more tools, there's pretty much always some kind of harvest and planting, seeding going on. But that won't be all that's going on, so hopefully we get to that point. It shouldn't be too far off to where we have continuous work going on. So I'll catch back up to you guys when the cultivator's done. Nope. And helper B is done. Oh, that's coming, right? Probably. Okay. Yeah, we're making progress on these trees. So hopefully the price goes up. I doubt it has, but yeah. Eventually it will. And when it does, we will be in a very good position. Okay. But yeah, so I'm gonna go ahead and say screw it, and we're gonna use the pickup to go grab the sheep. I know that didn't work out super well last time, but we're gonna go ahead and make it happen. Because, yeah, I wanna do something other than chop wood, so we're gonna go buy some more sheep. Ourselves 10 more sheep, which takes away a lot of our money, but based on how the animals are performing right now, I think that's okay. I think the sheep are gonna start being our cash cows, if you will, making us a good bit of money, which I'm excited for. I think we can do some pretty good things if we take the effort on the sheep. Beep, beep. Alright, let's just stop. Get control. Alright. If we let the sheep really, really flourish, I think we'll start getting a lot more wool, which will be good for us. Yeah. Yeah, see, it's weighing down heavily on the back of the pickup there. I'm sorry, sheep. I'm sorry. Good thing you're tightly packed in there. Oh, yeah, no one can move. I think I still have traffic off. Traffic off, yeah. Alright, there we go. Traffic's back. That was probably back when I was making the course play. Yeah, I think that's what it was. I was thinking I was making the course play course all the way to the gardening center. Not that we ever went back there or used the course. Pushing our engine to the limits here. Oh no. Thought I was gonna end up topped on that guardrail, and that would have been a problem. Would have had to get a tractor to come pull us out. Yeah. It shouldn't be as big a deal once we put all the sheep into the pasture. Let's see. Come on. Get it under control. Let's pull it in here. And unload. There we go. So I'm just gonna leave that there while I go feed everybody. I wonder if, I mean, this would obviously not work. There's no way. No way. That's ridiculous. Now, I did another mod that I'm not going to set up now, but the point of that mod is basically automated cleaning of the food troughs. You'll see when we get more than the sheep going that this becomes very quickly unruly, because the speed at which it becomes unclean is related to the number of animals that you have. So it'll get unclean faster now that we have 10 more sheep in there. Right. This might empty this. Yep, it does. So we will go fill it up. Let's see. From here, where's a good place to fill it up? Might be over by this bridge here. It kind of looks like there's a sandbank, but we'll see. Right, see? It's empty. It's really easy. It won't be when we fill it with water. Let's see. Let me drive down here. Whoa. So, I mean, it made it look like a sandbank. But it's not very good. I don't know if we could... Oh. That's the edge of the map, gents. Okay, never mind. I guess I will turn around. Yeah, let's just reverse out of here. What could we do? We could go to that same one that we used before, but on this side. Yeah, we'll do that. So we'll just drive along here. Yep. It's, I think this river's had better days, judging by the embankments here. Yeah, there have been better river days. Oh, it looks like this one's actually supposed to let us do that. Alright, so let's back it in here. Kind of screwed that up. Let's see. Alright. What am I? Following the... There we go, some nice free water. And then we'll take this over to the sheep. I wonder if how much water the sheep need. Okay, so we just barely didn't meet the sheep's needs. Alright. Yep, so it's a bit heavier. But it's definitely not like that, animal trailer. Oh, I mean, maybe it is. Maybe it's exactly like the animal trailer. Maybe I should shut my mouth. Yep. Like right here, this area would be great if we had the scorpion king. You gotta get the big one. So the little one doesn't do like the tall one, so like that guy right there, or this one right here, or this one right here. There's a lot of them, and there's no point in even trying if you don't have the big full-size one. You could always cut them by hand, but there's no point in really cutting them by hand, these trees by hand, when there's ones that you can't actually cut by hand. Whoa. Whoa. So that is exactly what would happen. Except it would then break something. a turn too sharp and stopped there. So it's good to know that there's some weight momentum physics in here, because I don't have enough power or weight in the pickup to actually stop this trailer. Now, ideally something that's carrying water of this, right? I mean, 7,300, I think that's probably in liters, is a ton of weight. So that's going to be double the weight of most, especially a pickup like this. It's absolutely going to be double that weight. So we'll just get it kind of close. Oh, nope, that'll work. So there we go. For 6 days. Let's see, so this guy's almost full. Yep, so the wool's picking up there. Right, so those additional 10 cut off almost 10 hours. Not 10 hours. Yeah. I guess 7. 7 hours in the reproduction rate. Which is good. We'll have more sheep faster, which is ultimately what we want. I don't know at what point I'll look at selling sheep. Probably once wool becomes really challenging to manage is when I'll make that switch. But until then... Yeah, we'll pretend this would work. Yeah, right. Alright. So let's head back to the farm. It's still kind of a heavy trailer. I mean, it's probably got to be hefty for putting a bunch of animals in it. Excuse me. Yeah, I think the sheep will be good for us. We've almost got a full pallet, which I believe is 2,000 wool. And it should keep making pallets until we're done, until it's full. So I think 6 fit in that square. So that'll be 12,000, which is about $36,000. Dollars. Oh, no. Come on. Yeah, we really shouldn't have done it with this pickup. Or we should have bought the bigger pickup. I bet it could do it. Well, eventually we'll get to tractor trailers, and those will do a lot better. Semi trucks. Eighteen-wheelers, as I grew up calling them, actually. Yep. Yeah, it's interesting. There's always terms like that that, at least in the States, I don't know how it is in the rest of the world, but depending on where you are in the particular area, I assume it's the same everywhere, because it's more of a cultural thing than a language thing. You use different words for different things. So, like, I always refer to what is soda as Coke. It's always Coke. What kind of Coke do I want? Then I want a Sprite, Pepsi, something like that. But it's always a Coke. And then here, where I live now in Colorado, is pop or soda. Both are used pretty interchangeably. And then, yeah, it's just... Back east where I went to school, I heard a lot more soda. I heard cola a couple times. That was interesting. But yeah, up. Helper H is out of seeds. Man, we need to get a bigger seeder. Because if it can't finish the field, what's the point? Right, and we are so close to finishing the field. So close. But it can't do it. Not with canola. We could switch and have that field always do like wheat or barley or something. That's not the worst idea I've ever had. Because that'll let us get another loader and do straw or bales. We might start baling stuff. I mean, the loaders make it easy, because you just, you don't really care, you don't have a lot of maintenance. But if you're going to store stuff, bales is exclusively the way to go. Okay. So you got another pass before you're finished. So I will chop more of these trees that I chopped down right before. I shifted everything. Yeah, I should be able to make some progress. That's, come on, I had you a second ago. And right there. Okay, let's see if I can pull this out. Okay, put it down. Let's cut you at this weird junction. Yep, and yep, that all disappeared. Which is fine. I'm going to be under the impression that if I chop it and it disappears, that means that it wouldn't have given me anything anyway. So, sticking to that philosophy. That's just the game, trying to keep it clean. Now, I might be wrong, but I am sticking to that being my answer. So I'm going to fill this up again because we don't want to run out of seed in the last 10 feet of the field and then kick ourselves because we didn't put the extra seed in. And then we'll probably go actually replace this cedar. We'll probably get a wider working width cedar, which conversely should hold more seed. So let's put him here. Awesome. Alright. I'll catch up with you when this cultivator over here is done, and we're going to put him on fertilizing. And in the meantime, I will chop more wood. Alright, so are you done? Yep, you are done. Awesome, so let's go take you. Sorry. We will put you away. Actually, maybe we'll clean you first. You are really exceptionally dirty. I'll clean. And I suppose I can gas it out too. Alright. Get this. Alright. It'd be nice if having things clean meant the maintenance is lower. I think I've said that before. But right now I think it's 100% aesthetic. I mean, or it could be inversely the other way. Having things dirty meant the maintenance is higher. Sure those windows are nice and squeaky clean. Ah. It's an economical engine, dude. There we go. See, it's a lot nicer when we have clean equipment. I think I'm going to. No, I'm not. I don't like to spend a bunch of time like that, or waste a bunch of time. So we will take the pickup truck with us. Actually, no. I'm gonna chop down trees over there. Right, eventually there will be treeless land. see we're making some progress. Next time we do wood chips, hopefully we've got bigger tippers so we can get the most money out of it, because, yeah, that's going to be an exceptional amount of money. Now, I think... Let me look. I think there's some, like, a heating plant right here, yep, that I believe you can use, and it basically skips the... Like, it's got a fixed price for the wood chips. Now, I don't know that for a fact, so I'll probably do some research. Actually, I might do it while this worker goes, so that's what I'm going to do. All right, so I will have the worker here do this. Oh, I was wondering why I was so slow. So I'll have the worker go and do this while I do the research on what the heating plant actually does. Alright, so there's apparently this. So, and note how it says sold to the sawmill. What are you doing? What are you doing? Alright, man. Workers. Okay, anyway. So there's those two things, right? There's the placeable chipper that immediately sells them, and then there's the heating plant. And based on this one article I found, and it's the only one I found on the first page of Google that talks about the difference in price. So according to this, the way we are doing it yields us about 10% more than if we were to use that placeable chipper and immediate sell thing. But if we were to use the heating plant, we would actually make about 20% less than the way we're doing it now. All right, so the best way to do it is to chip it the way we are and sell it at a point, which also gives us an advantage of great demands, as well as the price is slightly better. Whereas if you did the chipper with the immediate sell, so that's a fixed chipper, so you can't move it like the one we've got, but it chips and sells immediately, will yield us 10% less. But again, we don't have to go sell. Whereas if we did the heating plant, that would be... Right, so the numbers it's showing me is the placeable chipper that immediately sells, the one I was just talking about, should yield me about 8,000 per tree. Based on whatever settings he had his game in. Whereas the heating plant would be 7,000 per tree. So 7/8, which is like 16%. 12.5%. Yeah. Less. We don't want to do the heating plant. We want to stick with the way we're doing it. It's a little time consuming. But once we get rid of these oddly shaped trees, we can replace them and do the same process we are over at some of the more standard trees, like that big hill over there, and use some of the bigger machines that can actually carry the trees and manipulate them to actually put them in the chipper with those, which will be significantly faster than the way we're doing it here in terms of accumulating wood chips. But, of course, the downside of so many wood chips is it's going to drive the price down. So we're going to stick with the way we're doing it for a while, probably, because we've got a lot of trees that we want to get rid of to open up better grass fields. So we'll do that here, probably all around these fields. And by the time we're done with these, we'll probably buy this big field in front of us and things like that. So... I think we're going to be doing it the way we are currently doing wood chips for a long time. So, yeah, so that's the idea. Oh, looks like our other helper finished, so we'll be able to take the fertilizer here with the, like, no, don't you dare. Nope. No. It doesn't like to do what it's told. Yeah, I don't know. Ah, man. It doesn't look like the cedar actually finished this job either.
No.
Yeah, so we'll start this guy. It doesn't look like the cedar finished because he didn't want to, or she didn't want to. Don't discriminate. I hate all people that don't do their job equally. So let's see. Okay, now it just. Oh no, see, there's this little strip. That you didn't feel like finishing, huh? All right. Oh, we could use the train for wood chips. That's an idea. Is a good idea, right? Because if we fill the train up with the wood chips, because I bet it can hold a lot more, and then we sell it all at once, that's not a bad idea. But I don't know if the train here actually goes to a wood chip sell point. I mean the mill, but not lumberyard. There we go. So we'd have to go to the lumberyard, which I don't know if it actually has a price for wood chips. I think it's just those two places. Yeah, it's just these two. I guess lumberyard's not even listed here. Okay. So I'm gonna assume it takes it. We can go check it out. Which actually is probably the best idea. Oh, I almost ran into that. Yeah. Come on. Oh, seed, right? Okay. There we go. Alright, guys, so. That's the idea. We'll get to that eventually. For now, I'm going to call it an episode, guys. It's probably going to be a longer one, so I apologize if that's how it turns out. But otherwise, like, subscribe, and be sure to comment. I want to hear from you, good or bad. I appreciate all comments. Because at the end of the day, right, if you guys aren't enjoying it, I'm not going to force you to enjoy it. So, this is Dally. This has been another episode. Or, words are hard. This has been another Let's Play Farming Simulator 17 on Sosnovka. You guys have fun.